वेलकम बैक टू जेफ जियो एकेडमी। सो इन द लास्ट लेक्चर लेक्चर 3, आई हैव मेड सम मिस्टेक इन द एडिटिंग, सो द वीडियो इज रिपीटेड, वन क्लिप इज रिपीटेड 3 times, सो आई डिलीटेड दैट वीडियो। इन द नाउ आई विल अपलोड दैट वीडियो विथ दिस वीडियो, दैट मीन्स टूडे two lectures will be uploaded. So today our topic will be Kepler's law of planetary motion. So let's discuss the first law of planetary motion. So according to first law, it states that planets orbit in an elliptical orbit with sun at one of the focus. So let's illustrate this in the diagram. Suppose this is the Earth's orbit. It is revolving in this orbit. Now the sun is situated at, you know one thing, when we are considering an orbit, it must have two focus. This is one and this is two. So let this focus be F1 and this focus, let this focus be F2. Okay. Now the sun is situated at one of the focus. Suppose the sun is situated somewhere here. Now let our Earth is located somewhere here. Okay. Let the mass of the sun be M, capital M, and small m is the mass of Earth. Now I have told in the last lecture that every planet has two motion. One is rotation and another is revolution. So when it is rotating in its own axis, when the Earth is rotating in its own axis, it must have some velocity. So let that velocity be b. Okay. Now since it is also revolving around the sun, now it also must have some velocity. Let the velocity be v0, or we can say v0. Okay. So here I have written all those things. M is the mass of the sun, small m is the mass of the planet earth, and v0 is the revolution velocity of earth, and v is the rotation velocity, and let r is the distance between the sun and our earth. Okay. So what I am doing here is I will derive the formula. Okay. I will derive the formula from which numerical questions often asked in the exams. Okay. So let's discuss the formula. Now I am going to derive the formula, okay, of the velocity, revolutional velocity. So how I will derive? Look here, the gravity force. You have learned these things in your gravity lecture of class 12 or class 11, right? So the gravity force Fg is equal to gm by r square, the force between two object, the gravitational force between two object, g capital M small m by r square. You know the formula, F is equal to gm by r square. Okay. So here g is the universal gravitational constant. This is the constant value. Our variables are capital M, small m, and r. Now I have also discussed about the centripetal force. Now the centripetal force is equal to mv square by r, mv naught square by r. Okay. v0 is the revolutionary velocity. Now to balance the system, the balance would be system when the both the force Fg and CpF will be equal, when the gravitational force and the centripetal force will be equal, so that the system will be in equilibrium. Now here both the force would be equal, so gmm by r square must be equal to mv0 square by r. Now gmm by r square, v0 square by r, here small m cancel, r cancel. Now we are left with g capital M by r is equal to v naught square. Now here v naught u will be equal to gm by r root over, which I have written in this equation. So our final equation will be v naught will be equal to gm by r root over. Okay, now we are find this formula. Orbital velocity is equal to gm by r root over of gm open r. Now here we can conclude that from this equation the orbital velocity depends on, since g is fixed, it is a number only. Now the orbital velocity depends on mass of the sun and distance between sun and planet. Okay, sun and planet. So orbital velocity does not depends on, this orbital velocity does not depends on mass of the own planet. Okay, will only depend on mass of the sun only. So the duration of year, the duration of year depends on mass of sun as well as distance between sun and planet. So the year, the time for which it will cover, suppose this is the planet Earth, this is sun, it is revolving. So how much time it will take to reach the same point will depend on this mass, the mass of the sun. It does not depends on the mass of the planet. Okay, so the orbital velocity is directly proportional to the mass of the sun. Orbital velocity is directly proportional to mass of the sun, first. Second, orbital velocity is inversely proportional to distance between sun and planet. Okay, mass of the sun and inversely proportional to the distance between sun and planet. So when mass is larger, it will the orbital velocity will be larger and it will reach to the same point in the smaller time. It will require lesser time as compared to when the mass is smaller. Okay, now Kepler's second law. It states that the line connecting to a planet sweeps equal area in equal interval of time. So what does it means? See this illustration. This is the Earth's orbit. It is rotating in this orbit, revolution in this orbit. Now let the Earth is situated somewhere here at point P, and since it is revolving, now it comes to point Q. Okay, so since this is the sun. Now since it is situated as compared to this is nearer, so this position will be perihelion position. Okay, now it comes to point P dash. This is the point P dash. It comes to point P dash and it sweeps this much area, and now it reaches to point Q dash. Now according to this law, according to Kepler's second law, this much area must be equal to this much area. Okay, because the line connected to a planet sweeps equal area in equal interval of time. Because if this time is equal, suppose this time is t and this time is also t, so it must cover equal area, because equal area in equal interval of time, since the time in both the cases is same, so this area must be equal to this area. Clear? Now we know that area of arc sector is equal to half theta r square. Suppose this angle is theta 1, this angle is theta 1, and this angle is theta 2. And from this to this point, this is r1. From this to this point, this is r, from this to this point, this is r2. Okay, now for area a1, a1 will be equal to, a1 is the arc sector, this area A1, and this is A2. Okay, now for this arc sector, this is the arc sector. Area A1 will be equal to half of theta 1 R1 square. So this angle is theta 1, this distance is R1, so this will be area A1 will be equal to half theta 1 R1 square. Okay, now for area A2, for this area, this is also an arc sector. This is the arc sector. I am talking about this. Okay, this is the area A2. Now for area A2, A2 will be equal to half, this angle is theta 2 and this distance is R2, so this will be half theta 2 R2 square according to area of arc sector formula. Now according to Kepler's second law, this area must be equal to this area. So look, half theta 1 R1 square, half of theta 1 R1 square is equal to half of theta 2 R2 square, correct? Now half half will be cancelled out. Now we are left with theta 1 R1 square is equal to theta 2 R2 square. Okay, now theta 1, move this theta 2 to this side, left hand side. Now theta 1 divided by theta 2 will be left with R1 to this side, R2 square by R1 square, R2 by R1 whole square. Now R2 by R1 will be equal to theta 1 by theta 2 root over. Simple as that. Now we will learn Kepler's third law and we will do some numericals. Okay, numerical is important for us. If you are not good in numerical, you are not good in your concept. Now according to Kepler's third law, the square of orbital period t of a planet is proportional to the cube of the semi-major axis of the orbit. Okay, so the square of orbital period t square will be equal to cube of the semi-major axis. T square will be equal to r cube. You know the semi-major axis, I have talked about it in the previous lectures. So this is the earth and this is its semi-major axis and this is its semi-minor axis. Okay, now orbital period t, the formula of orbital period t is equal to 2 pi r divided by root over of gm by r. Now square t square will be equal to this whole square and it will give rise to this. Okay, t square is equal to 4 pi square r square divided by gm by r. Now r will move upward, 4 pi square r cube divided by gm, this one. Clear? So these are all the laws of planets which was given by Kepler. So this is all about the Kepler's laws of planetary motion. So if you have any doubt in this regarding this lecture, you can comment me and I will solve those doubt. Okay, now we are going to discuss some numericals. If you are not good in numerical, you are not good in your concept. Okay, this is our question. Two planets A and B orbit around their sun. Now two planets A and B, so the basic funda of solving any numerical question is first read the question and understand the thing, what this question wants from us. Okay, so first of all, see the data, what data he has given and what data he is asking with us. So the data given here is B being 4 times far away. than A from their sun. That means the sun is one and planet is two, and B is situated at a larger distance as compared to A. And how much distance, how much larger distance? 4 times as compared to A. Okay, 4 times far away than A from their sun. Then the length of year, he is asking about the length of year on B as compared to A would be dash. So he is asking us about the length of the year, means the duration of the year would be dash, same 2 time, 4 time or 8 time. Now first you have to think, this question is asked from which concept. So this question is asked from T square is equal to R cube. So this is Kepler's third law. So your mind must strike, this question belong to Kepler's third law. Now you have to first, if it is this type of question, you must make a diagram. Okay, now this is our sun, this is planet A and this is planet B. So in the question, suppose this distance is R, this is one planet, planet A, and this is planet B. So this question is, this distance, suppose this, I let this distance is R. So how much will be this distance according to our question? This will be 4R, because it is 4 times then R, 4 times the distance of first planet, planet A. Now this distance is R. Now we know the formula, T square is equal to R cube. Okay, so here we have to calculate T, the time period. T will be equal to root over of R cube. Let the time period of A is TA. Okay, so TA will be equal to R1. This is, suppose this is R1, this is R2. if this is R2, will be equal to 4R1. Okay, so TA will be equal to R1 cube root over. Okay, now we have given that for planet B, that is TB will be equal to R2 cube root over. Now this R2 will be equal to how much? 4R1. So I am putting the value 4R1 cube root over. Now this will 64R1 cube root over. Okay, now 64, here I am writing 64 root over R1 cube. Okay, so this will be root over, this is the cube now, this is cube, R1 cube. So this will 64, root over of 64 is how much? 8, and we are left with R1 cube. Now look here, R1 cube is equal to TA. So this will be 8 TA. So the answer will be 8 times. This is the correct answer. Okay, so the answer will be 8 times. Okay, so this is the end of the lecture. Thank you for patience. Now I would like to tell, if you want to join my Telegram channel, I have given the link in the description box. So you can join the Telegram channel and join us for more quiz questions. I have given many questions I have given in the quiz in my Telegram channel related to this topic. So thank you.